My drifting memory goes back to the spring of 43, when I was just a child in Mama's arms. My daddy plowed the ground and prayed someday he could leave this rundown mortgage Oklahoma farm. And then one night I heard my daddy saying to my mom that he'd finally saved enough to go. California was his dream of paradise, for he had seen pictures in magazines that told him.
Fantasy has always been very real for me. When I make machines, they become almost real. I worked for about 5 months building this machine, and this whole function, this one machine, was to go to Bonneville. And we built the thing. We worked all the way up till the last week that we were going to leave, and I got a professional painter, Chip Coffin, to paint it for me. And it was still wet when we loaded it. We loaded it in a large trailer in a truck, and I took a six-man crew. And we got in the GMC truck, and we drove 1,800 miles, and pulled it up on the salts, and played it. It wasn't just a game, an artist making a machine, making art. Hermen Goode became a team that was actually going to race and participate. And that way we did participate, you know. We lived on the desert. We drank the Coors beer, and we worked very, very hard. The North American culture is my culture. You know, the fast cars, the sex image, anything you want to say, and the good and the bad. You know, making Playboy was a fantastic thing for me. When I was in Playboy, you know, again, the American dream come true. When I was in art school, I kept separating aesthetics in my own personal life. At night, I was racing, or trying to race night and weekends on a dirt track. And I wasn't very good, but it was probably the most exciting thing that happened to me. And then maybe 4 or 5 years later, I finally put it together and found out that making the cars, you know, and the participation, was probably more exciting and more valid than making aesthetic art forms. I started building machines about 2.5 years ago. Making art is not just the ability to put pleasing aesthetics together or colors or shapes or forms. It's a lot more than that. It's your total involvement with life. I think my machines show it. The machine never ran. It never will run, you know. It's made its trip to Bonneville. Now it'll probably set in fine art places and fine art people will look at it. But while I was at Bonneville, I had a tremendous response from the people there. And the people really enjoyed it. They knew what it was. They knew that it wasn't going to run. But they liked it. They accepted it as art, probably more so than any gallery I'll ever put it in. I think the ability to make good art hinges on the ability to show your ass.